Hello, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use an HTML form to pass a few parameters to a server-side scripting language, in this case, PHP. So we're going to write a simple program that allows the form to pass the background color and the name of the user to a PHP script. So in order to create a form, I need to use the form tag. Form tag is a block level element, and by itself is just a container and a few attributes. Of course, when I create the form, I should be able to say where to send this information and how to send this information. So the very first attribute you need to know is action. Action specifies the destination URL, the server-side script URL, where you want to send all this information that the form collects from the user. So simply, in my case, it's going to be color.php because I want to use this form to change the background color of the PHP. There is another option you can add, or another attribute you can add. It's called method. The method specifies how do you want to send this information to the server or to that script. You want to send it through get method, which is going to be a bunch of parameters attached to the URL right after the question mark, or you just don't see anything and it will go to the server. So in this case, if I want to go ahead and use get, get is default. So if you don't specify the method altogether, by default, the form method is get. Also, the action is optional as well. So if you don't specify action, the form will be submitted to the same page. In this case, the page name is called f2.html. So if I just submit this without using the action, it will go to f2.html. Now, I'll go ahead and create our very first form element. The input tag is a magic tag. It does a lot of different form element for you. You always use the input with one exception in the type. So if you go ahead and just specify the type, you can have different types for the input box. For now, we just want to have a text box, one line text box, which I can enter the color. And definitely I have to give a name to this input box because that becomes the name of the parameter that I'm passing, and the value that gets into this input box or typed by the user into this input box become the value of the parameter. So in this case, I'm going to call it color. And simply when I'm done with this form, if I just go ahead and show you this, let me just bring up the thing. Okay, go ahead and prepare my browser here. So as you can see, there is one text box here, which I can type in, right? Of course, when you look at the form, there must be a way to submit this information to color.php. So one way would be to just hit enter while you are on the input box. So I can go ahead and type red and just click, right? Something like that. Or I can go ahead and have a submit button. Submit button is another type of input box. The type, of course, is submit, right? And if I just view the form now, you can see a submit button is added there too. I want to have another one. So this one is color, and I want to create another one for the name as well, right? So I will pass the name of the person and the color that they prefer to have. So in this case, now I have the color and the name. Of course, the missing part is the label of these elements, right? So there are two ways of doing this. I can go ahead and just put a string like this, color. So when you look at the form, you see the label is next to that. Or I can use a label tag, which allows me to attach the label by using the for attribute to any element in this form. So I just go ahead and put the label in there. Definitely, I go to the input box and I put the ID name. So the ID should match what you have as a value of the form, right? So if I go ahead and refresh this right now, you can see the name and color is there. Let me just put the colon here so they look the same. So both of them are there, right? So if I go ahead and say red and just John, when I submit the form, if you look at the URL, the parameters are passed to the URL. This is using get method. If you didn't watch this, you can use the first video in this series to get the idea about that. But simply collects those information and pass it to the server side script. One of the big differences between using a string like this or a label like this is this. If I go ahead and double click on desk color, nothing will happen. But as soon as I click on the name label, you see the cursor moves or put the focus on the text box that this label is holding the value for, right? Now, what I want to do is I want to go ahead and create the post method. So before I update this, if I go ahead and submit this one more time, Mary, and I submit this, this is what we get when we use the get method, right? Now I want to go ahead and change this to post and run the same way. So now what happened is if I go ahead and write glue Jack and hit submit, you don't see anything in the URL anymore. That is a post method. That's one of the differences between post and get. You don't see question mark, you don't see the parameter list. Ignore this part for now. I'm gonna fix these PHP code in a second. So one of the differences, I can simply go ahead and whenever I refresh the page, so if I click on refresh, it will actually gives me a confirmation box saying that you have submitted this form before. Are you sure you want to submit it again? So you either can say cancel or you can simply continue submitting the form again, right? I want to go ahead and fix my PHP code. This is what I had used in my first video. Get was letting me to get the value of the parameter when the method was get. Now that the method is post, I simply have to change the get to post, right? So I'll go do that now. And so now I'll go and pass the color yellow and John. Submit. Simply you can see my script works with post as well. So that was just the basic idea of creating a form and creating some field or a form element and submit the form using the post method. So to review this, action and method are both optional. If you do not specify the action, the information will be submitted to the same page that contains the form. Method is by default get. Get shows the parameter on the URL and post does not. You refresh the URL that was posted. The browser will ask you if you want to resubmit or not. We can add a label as single text like this, or we can use a label. If you use a label, you have to use the for attribute, and the value of the for is the ID of the element that you want to attach this label to that. Thank you for watching, and I'll continue with the rest of the material in the form element in other videos. Thank you.